Hi students, in this module we are going to discuss about the Kuntz rule and Pauli's exclusion principle. Before module we already discussed a very important topic, that is Aufbau principle and applications of the Aufbau principle. Let us come to Kuntz rule. In this Kuntz rule, first of all we are going to learn what is meaning of a degenerate orbitals. Degenerate orbitals, see this definition: the orbitals belongs to the same subshell with equal amount of energy. The conditions are they must and should belong to the same subshell and they have equal amount of energy. How to calculate the energy? Energy of an orbital is calculated by n plus l value. Okay, see here, comes to the example 1. L is equal to 1, that is equal to p sub level, we already know. Now how many orbitals are there? It contain 3 orbitals. How? By applying the formula 2l plus 1. This is the formula for number of orbitals that are present in a sublevel as per the magnetic quantum number. Now how many orbitals are there? That is 3. By applying 2 of 1 plus 1, that is 3. As per the magnetic quantum number, their values are minus 1, 0, plus 1. Why? Because they start at minus L, 0 and as well as plus L. Now we are going to represent them by using in the form of a box. Let the first one along the direction of x-axis is called px, along the direction of y-axis is called py, along the direction of z-axis is called pz. Now here energy of px is equal to energy of py is equal to energy of pz. All these three orbitals which they belongs to the same subshell, that is p sub level, and has equal amount of energy. Now this px is equal to py is equal to pz is called degenerate orbitals. Let us come to the second example, sub level d, whose l value is equals to 2. L is equals to 2. As per the formula 2l plus 1, the number of orbitals are 5, 2 of 2 plus 1, that is 5. Those 5 magnetic quantum number values are minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Why? Because totally how many orbitals are there? 5 orbitals are there. These 5 orbitals is represented as dxy is equals to dxz is equals to dyz is equals to dx square y square is equals to dz square. This means energy of these 5 orbitals are same. Now those orbitals are said to be degenerate orbitals. Now from this explanation we can understand that a very important definition: orbitals belongs to the same subshell. It may be belongs to p, or it may be belongs to d, or it may be belongs to f. Same subshell and equal amount of energy is called degenerate orbitals. Examples are px is equal to py is equal to pz, or dxy is equal to dxz is equal to dyz is equal to dx square y square and dz square. Why? Because they are located along the particular axis. For that sake only we are terming them as dxy, dxz, dyz, dx square y square and dz square. Let us discuss now what is Kuntz rule. Now let us see the statement of Kuntz rule depending upon the degenerate orbitals. For that sake only we already given a clarity what is meaning of a degenerate orbital. See the statement: pairing of electrons in the orbitals starts only when all the available degenerate orbitals are singly occupied. A little bit confusion is there in the statement. So to avoid that, we should write electronic configuration of some of the elements. For example, say I am going to write electronic configuration of carbon. General representation of carbon is C6 12, as we already know. This contains 6 electrons, 6 protons, 12 minus 6, 6 neutrons. These 6 protons and 6 neutrons are present inside the nucleus. Very good. Now, what about these 6 electrons? As per the Moiler chart and as well as Hofbauer principle, these are all the 6 electrons. First, we will try to occupy the 1s orbital. So, in the 1s orbital, 2 electrons are occupied. Why? Because every orbital can accommodate 2 electrons. Remaining how many electrons? 4 electrons. All the 4 electrons, again after 1s, the next orbital is 2s. So, the electron enter into the 2s. 2s which is having 1 orbital, it can accommodate only 2 electrons. Next, remaining electrons are 2. Those 2 electrons, as per the Moiler chart and as well as Hofbauer principle, they enter into 2p. We left only 2 electrons, so for the 2 electrons enter into the 2p. Now, by giving a Bronk representation, we can explain like this. As per the Bohr and Burri model, we can draw like this. In the case of 2s2, 2 electrons are there. As per the spin quantum number, one is in the clockwise, another one is in the anti-clockwise. Here also 2 electrons are there. As per the 2p, here one is in the upward direction, another one is in the downward direction. This is the wrong method. Why? As per the statement, pairing of electrons in the orbitals starts when we have to pair. If all the empty orbitals are singly occupied, now the correct method is as per the 1s and as well as 2s. In the case of 2p, first we should fill up with the px of 1 electron and as well as py with 1 electron. Now this becomes the correct method. Pairing of electrons starts only all the available degenerate orbitals are singly occupied. This means every orbital we should occupy with 1 electron, then we should do the process of pairing. Let us discuss one more example. As in the case of fluorine, in the case of second example, fluorine, we already know the general representation of fluorine is 9F19. This means it contains 9 electrons, 9 protons, 19 minus 9, that is 10 neutrons. Now, these 9 protons and 10 neutrons are there inside the nucleus. What about these 9 electrons? As per the Moiler chart and as well as Hofbauer principle, these are all the 9 electrons first are try to occupy the lowest energy, that is 1s. So, in the 1s, because of the presence of 1 orbital, it can accommodate only 2 electrons. Remaining 7 electrons will try to occupy the 2s orbital, but only 2 electrons are occupied. Remaining 5 electrons will try to occupy the p orbital, that is now it becomes 2p5. Why? Because there is a chance of 6 electrons in the case of p, but because only 5 electrons are there, so the 5 electrons are occupied. Now, as per the Bohr and as well as Burri model, if you want to give the block representations, here, in the case of 1s, 2 electrons are there. In the case of 2s also, 2 electrons are there. 2p, 5 electrons are there. 1, 2, 3. Then pairing we should start 4 and as well as 5. This is the exact correct method. And if you see in the case of nitrogen, this becomes N714. This means which contains 7 electrons, 7 protons and as well as 7 neutrons. 14 minus 7, that is 7 neutrons. 7 protons and 7 neutrons are there inside the nucleus. Then what about these 7 electrons? These are all the 7 electrons as per the Moiler chart and as well as Hofbauer principle. They try to occupy the 1s orbital. 2 electrons are occupied. Remaining 5 electrons are there. As per the chart, they enter into the 2s.
S orbital can accommodate maximum of 2 electrons only. Then later they enter into the 2p. Now the electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Now as per the Bohr and Guri model, we can draw like this. Here in 1s, 2 electrons are there, 2s, 2 electrons are there, 2p, 3 electrons, 1, 2, 3. This is the wrong representation. Why? Because pairing of electrons starts only when every orbital singly occupied. Then what is the correct representation? Here 1s with 2 electrons, 2s with 2 electrons, 2p with 1, 2, 3. This is the correct method of representation of different kinds of orbitals in the degenerate orbitals. See the statement now. Pairing of electrons in the orbitals starts only when all the available degenerate orbitals are singly occupied. Here, pairing will starts only after single electron. Let us discuss what is Pauli's exclusion principle. With examples, then we will come to the statement. For example, we are writing the electronic configuration of nitrogen, where atomic number is 7, mass number is 14. Now here it contains 7 electrons, 7 protons, 14 minus 7, 7 neutrons. As per the electronic configuration, its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and as well as 2p3. Now, by giving the Bohr model, Bohr-Guri model, this is the block representation. S contain 2 electrons and as well as 2s contain 2 electrons. 2p, as per the Hund's rule, pairing will be taken place like this. Now, I am going to write the quantum numbers for any 2 electrons. Let us consider, I am going to write the quantum numbers for the 2 electrons of 1s. Means in the case of 1s2, 2 electrons are present. Now, for the first electron, I am going to write the quantum numbers. For the first electron quantum number n, here the quantum number n is equal to 1. Now, for the next quantum number is l. For s, l is equal to 0. If l is equal to 0, ml is also 0. Now what is the last one? Ms is equal to plus half. Why? Because the first electron is in the upward direction, that is in the clockwise. So it is represented as plus half. Then comes to the second electron. This means I am writing the quantum numbers of the second electron. Here n is equal to 1. Why? Because the first quantum number, first principal level. And l is equal to 0. Why? Because that electron is there in the sub level s. And as well as where L is equals to 0, ML is also becomes 0, then MS is equals to minus half. If you observe, maximum of 3 quantum numbers becomes same, but there is a difference in the 4th quantum number. That only the given statement, see here, no 2 electrons in the same atom. Those 2 electrons must and should be there in the same atom. Cannot have 4 quantum numbers same. Means there is no, for example, say 3 quantum numbers may be same, but there is a difference in the 4th quantum number. Now let us consider one more example in this situation only. Here what is that example? I am considering the here 1s2 and as well as, or otherwise we can consider the first electron of 2p. Third electron of 2p, first electron of 2p, this is the first electron of 2p, and this is the third electron of 2p. In the case of the first electron of 2p, n is equals to 2. For p, l is equals to 1. Where l is equals to 1, ml value, the first electron is there in this. Now ml is equal to plus 1. The electron is in the upward direction, so ms is equal to plus half. Then come to the third electron, where here n is equal to 2. Why? Because the principal quantum number. for p l is equals to 1. Now here the third electron is there here. Now the ml is equals to minus 1. Now ms is equal to, the electron is in the upward direction, it is also represented as plus half. See here, there is a difference in the magnetic quantum number. That means though remaining three quantum numbers are same, there must and should be a difference in the fourth quantum number. Let us consider one more example regarding this only. For example sake, we are going to consider the electron of 2s, that will be second electron of 2s, second electron of 2s and second electron of 2p, second electron of 2s. If we represent the 2s like this, 2p we can represent like this, 1, 2 and 3. Now I required second electron of 2s, this is the second electron of 2s, then n is equals to 2, l is equals to 0, ml is equals to 0, ms is equal to minus half. Now second electron of 2p, this is the second electron of 2p. For here n is equals to 2, l is equals to 1. Why? Because for p orbital, where l is equals to 1 in the middle, ml is becomes 0. Then what about ms? Ms is equal to plus half. See here, there is a similarity is there only in the main level, but angular momentum quantum number ml is, l is changed, ml is changed and the spin is also changed. That means here a statement is provided, no two electrons of the same atom can have all the four quantum numbers same. What does it mean? As per this number or as per this principle, an orbital can hold only two electrons. Only two electrons will be there. Why? Because with one is positive spin, another one is opposite spin. Means both, every orbital can accommodate with only two electrons. There is no chance of third electron. If the orbital will be there without any electron, zero electrons, or otherwise one electron, maximum is two electrons. This is the explanation about the Hund's rule and as well as Pauli's exclusion principle, which we are using in writing the electronic configuration. In my next video, we are going to say how to write the electronic configurations. Thank you.